So here we're gonna find the remainder when 2 to the power of 1000 is divided by 13. Since 13 is a prime number and 13 is not a multiple of 2, we can use the Mod's little theorem to find the remainder. According to the Mod's little theorem, a to the power of p minus 1 is congruence to 1 mod p, where p is a prime number and a belongs to the integers. Also, a is not a multiple of p. So we have p equals to 13 here and a equals to 2. Hence, we can write 2 to the power of 13 minus 1 is congruence to 1 mod 13. This is equals to 2 to the power of 12 is congruence to 1 mod 13. Now we need 2 to the power of 1000. When you divide 1000 by 12, it gives 83 with a remainder of 4. Hence, we have to take the power 83 to both sides of this notation. This is in accordance with the law of modular notation. If a is congruence to b mod n, then a to the power of m is congruence to b to the power of m mod n. Now this gives 2 to the power of 12 multiplied by 83 is 996 is congruence to 1 to the power of 83 is 1 mod 13. In order to get 2 to the power of 1000, we have to multiply both sides of this notation by 2 to the power of 4. This is in accordance with the law of modular notation. If a is congruence to b mod n, then k multiplied by a is also congruence to k multiplied by b mod n. Hence, this gives 2 to the power of 1000 is congruence to 2 to the power of 4, which is 16, mod 13. This is our first equation. When you divide 16 by 13, it is equals to 1 with a remainder of 3. Hence, 16 is congruence to 3 mod 13. This is our second equation. Now, according to the rule of modular arithmetic, if a is congruence to b mod n and b is congruence to c mod n, then a is congruence to c mod n. So this is our a, this is our b, and this is our c. Hence, from equation 1 and 2, we can write 2 to the power of 1000 is congruence to 3 mod 13. Hence, when you divide 2 to the power of 1000 by 13, it gives a remainder of 3. Hence, the answer is 3. 3 is our remainder.